public parks are an essential resource for physical and mental health and well-being. Albert Park is one of the jewels in the city of Port Phillip. More than 6 million visitors come here each year to play sport, take it easy, or engage in more colourful pursuits. In fact, Albert Park makes up about 60% of the open space within the municipality. As well as being a centre for a range of state, national or international sports and events, it's a vital resource for the residents of Port Phillip. And with numerous housing and apartment developments going up nearby and the local population growing, more and more people are using the park and its resident clubs and facilities.
There are so many kids now. People aren't moving out of the area. They're staying here. They're renovating their homes. And we're just bulging at the seams. We really are just about at capacity of what we can do simply because of the lack of facilities that we actually have access to.
I feel the council does ignore it to a certain extent. And so some focus, some investment, because many people in the area use it. And it's increasing more and more every time I come down there.
But look in the council records and budget, and you'll hardly see a mention of Albert Park. That's because Albert Park is not actually a part of the city of Port Phillip. It's owned by the state government and managed and funded by Parks Victoria. The city of Port Phillip actually makes minimal contribution to the equipment, facilities and activities that go on in the park, which sounds like plain good luck for Port Phillip. And in fact, last financial year, the city of Port Phillip spent much less on parks, recreation and leisure than its neighbours did. But for the thousands of Port Phillip families who regularly use Albert Park, it's a poor deal. More than 40% of the sports clubs in the municipality are based in Albert Park. Parks Victoria charges community clubs much more to use the facilities in Albert Park than similar clubs pay in the city of Port Phillip or other municipalities. And with higher costs and virtually no support or investment from the council, many locals from these clubs feel ignored and shortchanged.
Let's have some contribution, financial contribution, so that we can improve what we have instead of having to rely on scratching for grants here and there all over the place to try to achieve what we want to achieve for the local community.
Port Phillip Council does recognise that it's dropped the ball on sport and recreation. Last year, it produced its first ever sport and recreation strategy, intended to last 10 years till 2024. But while it's a useful stocktake of the needs and activities of the city's residents, it has very little by way of specific initiatives, and it assumes no extra funding for sport and recreation from the council.
Sport and recreation is an absolutely fantastic way for people to get involved and participate, you know, in all sorts of community activities.
It's certainly a home for people to turn to and enjoy the social side of things as well as competing in sport, really, we enjoy it.